Okay, so here's the deal. Normally I wait for overnight if I can, but I really need these things, and they're kind of prototypes, but I think they could actually turn out being for a real bed. So it's been about 4 hours, but if you recall, I put the there was also some white, some regular conventional glue in there with it. And you know, if you read the instructions on Gorilla Glue, they tell you to add moisture to it, like water or spray it or something. I'd never do that because I want the set time to be longer and allows me to more time for movement. But it also seems to foam up a little thicker. It's more dense foam rather than an airy honeycomb foam. So just my preference, right? But this has a bunch of white glue with it, which of course has a lot of moisture, and therefore I think it's set up a lot faster, and it even bubbled more than typical. But those bubbles or that oozing has like a lot of air in it, and I don't think that's going to seal quite as well. Anyhow, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to strip off just the top clamps, because then that allows me, by leaving it clamped into the micro bench on the lower clamps, it allows me, you know, a lot more strength to do what I need to do as far as the glue goes. So sometimes, especially with Gorilla Glue, you can't go right to the impact because the Gorilla Glue expands and it actually tightens the glue up. This is why I like the clamps, because like if this were a Bessie, you know, like a typical, I don't have any laying around here, but the typical, you know, with the wooden handle on them, when that expands, that thing comes so tight you can't even get the handle off. You know what I mean? You have to put a wrench on the handle. So anyways, that's what I'm gonna do here. Just loosen those up with the regular wrench. Okay, now we're still recovering from shoulder surgery from, what do you call it? Anyhow, you know what I'm talking about. But, so I have to be a little careful about, you know, quick slams, right? Doctor's orders. But that's basically all that it's taking is just, look at that. You know, a lot of people freak out at Gorilla Glue. It's just that if you have one of these, it's the end of your problems. Again, I'm not sponsored by anybody, but this particular one, the red-handled hide, bent chisel something, extra heavy duty 3-inch. It just works. I don't know if there's a model. It says 12070. I don't know if that's the model. Anyhow, but, and then put it, not like that, but like this. It just comes right off. And it's so clean that you hardly have to do anything else. So we'll just see what I all want to do here. Again, I'm doing this thing on the fly. There were no designs, nothing. So we'll see what happens. Next, I'm going to take off the lower clamps, and then I'm going to flip it, and then again, keep it in the one clamp on. So just snugging up one of the four clamps, just enough to hold it so that I can do my thing with the scraper. Great, gonna do the same for the second one. Same thing, loosen the clamps, etc., etc. We have dogs, by the way, that if I leave this on the ground, they tend to like, what's that? You know, I'm not sure if it's good for them, so I just pick it up.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's just take a good close look at this, right? That is pretty sweet. Now, again, right there, just a little bit of a gap, right? And again, because I had that liquid in there, the other type of glue, it's set a little faster, and the bubbles were a little more honeycomb-ish. But I like the looks of that kind of stuff, and we'll see how it turns out after we work it. So that's really the end of the glue up part. Now we're going to kind of go back to shaping the materials a little bit. Cover that.